Hello everyone. Am I audible? Great, thank you. Actually, there was some change of situation. I'm driving and I'm talking to you. I'm sitting in my car, and Jagpal sir is driving. Jagpal sir, have you joined? Just a moment, let me confirm if Jagpal sir has. Guys, I have stopped driving. I'm not driving and talking. I'm sitting. The car is on hold. Don't worry. वैसे भी हमारे साथ एक बड़े रिस्पॉन्सिबल पुलिस ऑफिसर जुड़े हुए हैं, वो वैसे मेरा चालान काट देंगे ऑनलाइन पे. Guys, give me just 1 minute. I'm on it. I'm asking my team to set the things right. साहिल यार, एक सेकंड ना, तू एक काम कर, उधर ते जगपाल सर हुन करो तो सीधा नो करता पैनलिस्ट अपग्रेड होने हरित ने. जुगपाल सर, सॉरी फॉर दिस बदरेशन स्टूडेंट्स, थोड़ा सा कुछ प्रॉब्लम आ गया था मेरे को ऑफिस में आज, सो आई वाज जस्ट रनिंग पिलर टू पोस्ट. अभी जगपाल सर को मैंने पैनलिस्ट बनवाया है. इट विल टेक अस टू मोर मिनट, 2-3 मिनट्स, और इतने में जगपाल सर आके हमें ज्वाइन कर लेंगे. एनीथिंग यू वांट टू से बिफोर दैट, यू फील फ्री एंड आस्क मी. I'm not driving, don't worry guys, I'm not driving. I'm sitting in my car, not driving at all. I hope Jagpal sir will be online with us in another 1 minute now.
यार मेरी आवाज
हाँ जी जगपाल सर, वेलकम जी.
सर कैन यू हियर मी नाउ?
यस आई कैन हियर यू, आई कांट सी यू, योर कैमरा इज नॉट ऑन सर.
कैमरा कैमरा किधर गई?
यू आर ऑडिबल सर नाउ.
ओके सर.
So here you
can
are.
You hear me now, sir?
I can hear you and see you. Thank you, sir. Thank you for taking out time during these busy days.
Good evening, sir.
अच्छा सर, ऐदां जगपाल सर, मैं तुहानूं ना 4-5 मिनट बाद ज्वाइन करांगा. मैं गड्डी रोक के सड़क ते खड़ोता तां गल कर रहा, मैं घर पहुंच रहा 5 मिनट च. आई विल बी ज्वाइनिंग यू, तद तक तुसीं जस्ट स्टूडेंट से 2-4 डाउट्स ले लो बस. राइट सर, आई विल बी ज्वाइनिंग यू बैक इन अनदर 5 मिनट्स.
हेलो हेलो।
हेलो हेलो
हेलो हेलो। See, I cannot listen to anybody. Like, I don't know. Okay. ओके सो वन मैसेज एट अ टाइम है। ओके यार सो आई टेक फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम हरदीप। ही इज आस्किंग लाइक डू वी नीड टू टेक पैरेलल नोट्स और शुड दीज क्लासेस आर सफिशिएंट। सी I'll tell you very honestly that you have to understand one thing, that coaching is to enable you to understand yourself and your preparation better. But eventually, you are the one who will decide whether you will require further notes, whether whatever is being taught in class is sufficient. Because I'll share my experience. Like, you know, every person is different. Every person is unique. Every person's preparation method is unique. Style is unique. Speed is unique. So my request to all of you is that through your
preparation, through your studies, try to understand yourself better. Once you will realize what kind of, you know, personality you are, so you will prepare yourself accordingly for this exam. See, this exam has no science behind it. Like you cannot say, oh, you do all five things and you'll clear this exam. No, that is not at all possible. Now, I understood your question here. I'm coming on to that, but I have to make it a little general. See, I'll start with an example. For example, what is federalism? Hardeep Singh, tell me, what is federalism? See, if anybody asks you anything about anything, so you have to explain it in two ways. One is the philosophy behind it, and second, the practice. That is why, okay, so Hardeep Singh is replying different levels of government. That is federalism. How about you go to class 9th or 10th NCERT, you open up chapter on federalism. I'm unable to recall properly whether it was in class 9th or 10th, but one of these NCERTs, Democratic Politics 1 and 2, the very first paragraph of the chapter on federalism, it is written, it is a power-sharing formula. See, look at how one half a sentence, one keyword has changed the entire dynamics of your answer writing. Now, this is what is required to clear this exam. That you require a perspective wherein, in minimum possible words, you can express yourself maximum possible. Now, if I were to say what is federalism, federalism is a power-sharing formula in which power is divided vertically as well as horizontally. How vertically? Vertically between states and center. Horizontally, between states, different powers. Between different organs of center. Though we call it as separate organs of government, but you know, if you look at it, that even the Rajya Sabha, Lok Sabha, they are like, they represent federal structure, though they are part of union legislative making only. So, okay, Shubham is saying federation is the act of joining states or other groups. Yes, federalism to that extent, yes. Then, you know, in social sciences, there is not one answer to anything. It's not science, proper science, that it's so objective. Like coming together for federation, bringing together federation, that is again that how states are, you know, they come together to find form of federation. For example, in US, every state has its own flag. Every state has its own governor. To the extent that this federation was thought to be that any state can leave also. If you look at it, like you'll hear many parties in Texas who are saying that we leave American Federation. It's too regressive for us. Same, you know, so it's federalism. It has various forms in practice. So we have to understand federalism as an idea, the philosophy behind it. And in a very simple words put together, federalism is power sharing. Formula of power sharing. It depends upon various factors, how it came about, how it is progressing. For example, if you look at it, India only, I'll make it general, don't worry, don't ask too many general questions. I mean, too many specific questions. I'll try to answer as many queries possible. But let me first finish what I have started through one example, what I'm trying to portray. Now, in India, even the federalism is of various, there is fiscal federalism. If you look at GST, if you look at how many states, they are clamoring against GST, that GST is not good for them because they have lost their taxing power. So whenever you prepare a certain topic, it has to be done holistically. Federalism, the idea, federalism, the practice, then specific Indian context, fiscal federalism, legal or say, you know, legislative federalism. Then there are special provisions, like, for example, the part of India where I currently work. I am posted in Shillong. I am in Meghalaya. If you look at Northeast, Northeast has so many special provisions vis-a-vis, you know, mainland India or other states, which they do not. So federalism, at one sense, it's acting as protective thing also, right? Chalo, now I'll make it general. Yeah, too many people are asking too many questions. Let us try to make it general. Who am I? First, I'll give you a little bit of introduction. One person is incessantly asking, only toppers clear this exam? No, yeah, only hard workers clear this exam. Hard workers who have the capacity. Always remember, UPSC preparation is marathon. It's like every day you have to get up, you have to follow a certain regime which is suitable to you. For example, there are people who get up early in the morning. There are people who study till late. I'll share my strategy with you. I always used to, you know, study in short spans. Like I would study for 3-4 hours in the morning, then take 1-2 hours break, study for another three, four hours. Afternoon, take 1-2 hour break, and you know, then later evening also during nighttime, 3-4 hours. So the best days would come out to be, you know, 10-12 hours. Normal days, you somewhere finish around 6-7 hours of good quality study. Second thing I would suggest you guys look for some library nearby. Okay, so Shubham is asking, I have to introduce my, okay, I'm Indian Police Service 2016 batch, rank 184, very poor academic award to the extent that 1 year prior to that, my interview, I scored 118. Next year in which I got selected, I was not even bothered because I realized that I will never clear this exam. It was my third attempt. So I scored actually third maximum in India, all over India, in interview. 203, if I'm not wrong, or 204. So yeah, that is why I'm telling you, it's random. It's random. Oh, bhai, pehle hi interview ke baad ki baatein. So it's totally random. So that is why from your side, what is required? Don't think about clearing this exam. Take one day at a time. Prepare yourself slowly but steadily. Read, my advice to you would be, read 3-4 newspapers a day, because they will enable you to be in touch with the present. And the most of the questions, if you pick up this mains examination and prelims, though, you know, 30-40% are current affairs based. And the questions which are asked in, say, polity or economy or science or environment or, you know, other than history and geography, those questions will be asked which have some relevance, some connection with the present, something. Like they'll ask you a question about some cave which was excavated recently, like in the last 2-3 years. So that is why these current affairs, they become very, very important for this preparation. And I would suggest, like, you should go for 3-4 newspapers. First, Indian Express, the quality of journalism in Indian Express is marvelous. Second, The Hindu. Third, one newspaper with economic background, be it Business Standard or, you know, Live Mint. And then one newspaper, for example, if you live in, say, Chandigarh and areas around Chandigarh, Tribune is good. If you live in southern part of India, Deccan Herald is good. That way you will have to pick and choose. Regarding this thing, magazines. See, there is no end to it. But you also have to understand, this exam is about don'ts are more important than do's. Do to yaar, you can pick up every book under the sun and keep on preparing for it. No, you're not preparing for PhD. You are preparing for one very general examination, which means your don't list should be more than your do list. So don't, I always consider magazines and don't list. If you are reading 4 newspapers a day, you do not need anything else. Seriously, you do not need anything else for as far as your current affairs and, you know, your context-specific preparation is done. Okay, how to cover 4 newspapers and what to read? Learn for yourself. I'll tell you, it's been 4 years I have cleared this exam. I still read 5 newspapers a day in 30 to 45 minutes. It becomes your habit. So make it your habit. Science and technology, okay. Newspapers are sufficient. Basic notes are sufficient. How many questions you get from science and technology in this exam? See, you have to understand, this examination is not for, like, it's like you have to make your own draft or craft your own strategy, your own tactics. For example, I'll share again mine. Here I completed no paper in mains. No paper. Not even optional, not even general studies. What I did, if I do not know anything about 2 questions, I'll leave them blank. I will not take my chances. So that is what I did. Now, again, I repeat, you have to craft your own strategy. There are people who will get average marks in every question. There are people who score outstanding in, say, 10 questions, but fail miserably in other 10, which means you are not getting selected. So you have to understand, in the exam, your aim should be to complete, okay, my marks in political science. In the year which I really got defeated in interview, I scored 251 marks in pol science. The year which I got selected, and that was the year I was teaching political science for a year and a half, my marks were 190. See, that is why I'm telling you that this exam is totally random. The year I was more prepared for political science, you know, it's been a year and a half I'm teaching, my marks dipped by solid 61 marks. So that is why I'm telling you all, guys, this exam is very random. All you can do is you can control the kind of effort you are putting into it. Now, talking generally about pol science. See, pol science is a wonderful, wonderful optional. But I will request all of you to think twice before taking this optional. You know why? Because for any optional, you will have to think twice. Why? Because it must match your interest. For example, my optionals were history and pol science. So these were the optionals which matched my taste about things in general. Like, I would randomly read books on history and politics. For example, if you have taste about sociology, okay, pick up sociology. But pol science is one such optional. If you take it, you will realize your journal studies, almost 50% of your journal studies is covered in political science, including essay. See, look at the paper one. Your answers will have a lot of value addition through pol science. Paper two is totally quality plus, you know, other international relations, which is again part of political science. Paper three, economy, okay, totally outside the purview of political science. But then security part, again, you will have to, you know, prepare it in political science. Even paper on ethics, the kind of thinkers you will be reading in, you know, preparing in political science, ranging from Aristotle to Plato to Marx to, you know, Gramsci. Even Indian thinkers, you know, Aurobindo Ghosh, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, you will realize that the only thing you have to prepare in journal studies is actually economics and maybe little bit of geography and history and culture and science and technology. But all other general subjects like security, polity, you know, even social issues, your ethics, they will be covered wholesomely in international relations, wholesomely in your optional. So this is the good thing about this optional. But again, I will tell you, you can only prepare this optional well if you have interest in it. Now, talking specifically about this optional, political science and international relations, I'll start with the easiest part, which is international relations. See, in international relations, all you have to understand is maybe 5 to 6 school of thoughts, realist, constructivist, idealist, you know, a Marxist. Once you understand the basic school of thoughts of, you know, having said that, it's not that easy that you'll prepare it in a day or two. No, because once you will understand the realist school of thought, there is classical realism, there is structural realism, you know, so many functionalist school, blah, blah, blah. So yes, it will take some time. But once you have those things in your grasp, every answer has to flow through prism of these schools only. For example, if you are reading Indian Express, there is one, I'm forgetting the name of that chap, South Indian chap, who writes extensively about international affairs in Indian Express. Can somebody tell me his name? C. Raja Mohan. Now, if you look at C. Raja Mohan, just you do one thing. Today you go home, the recent article written by C. Raja Mohan, you just cut it, paste a copy of it in your notebook. Then you prepare international relations for 1 month. Then you read the article written by C. Raja Mohan. You'll realize he is writing all the theories of international relations in his articles. It's just he's juggling with the facts. Now, this approach of writing articles or answer writing is known as eclectic approach. What is eclectic approach? Which means you do not belong to a particular school of thought. You will pick and choose all the best applicable theories and schools of thoughts, will put them on paper, and you will present it as your answer or your article. Now I repeat the word again, eclectic. That is the key to clear UPSC. That you should not be seen as a person who belongs to a particular school of thought or particular theory. You should be the person who understands each and everything. Here, one person, he's average guy. He's asking me too many times, can average guy clear this exam? Haan bhai, sab clear kar sakte hain. Provided you can put sufficient amount of effort, and your luck is there. The one who is sitting and giving you gyan is an average guy only. Totally average.
That's being very modest of you, Jagpal sir.
No, sir.
I have seen you working too hard so long.
No. See, that is what, no, average guys, is just you have to prepare for marathon more. See, if you are, your body is well equipped to, you know, run 20 kilometers a day. You compare that to a person whose body is equipped only to run 1 kilometer a day. So which means the one who can only run 1 kilometer, if he wants to run 20 kilometers, he has to put more effort. It is as simple as that. Like, it is not average guy or brilliant guy. No, it is the amount of effort you put in with the right kind of perspective. And finally, after two years of good preparation, that is the last stage where your luck will decide. Because I have seen people far, far brilliant than me not clearing this exam. And I'm telling you, once you clear this exam, your first reaction is, yaar, ye bhi select ho gaya. You know, you seriously see so many stupid people clearing this exam also. So it is equally true. But to trigger your luck equation, luck quotient, I would say first you will have to put solid effort of year and a half. Solid. And for that, as I have told you, your general knowledge, which will come from your daily newspaper reading, your general understanding of things. And then optional, yes, the most important part of this exam are actually optional and essay. Because general studies, more or less, you'll score average marks, because after preparation of year and a half, your general understanding of things grows to that level. See, sir, too many questions are being asked, and you know,
let's keep it simple. Let's keep it simple, sir. I know these students will ask so many questions because they usually don't have patience to listen to us. ਮੇਰੇ ਨਾਲ ਵੀ ਆਈ ਹੋ ਰਿਹਾ ਜਦੋਂ ਮੈਂ ਕਲਾਸ ਪੜਾ ਰਿਹਾ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਨਾ ਫਿਜ਼ੀਕਲ ਕਲਾਸਰੂਮ ਵਾਸ ਟੋਟਲੀ ਡਿਫਰੈਂਟ ਆਨਲਾਈਨ ਇਜ਼ ਵੈਰੀ ਡਿਫਰੈਂਟ ਤੇ ਮੈਂ ਇਦਾਂ ਕਰਦਾ ਮੈਂ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਤੋਂ ਨਾ ਇੱਕ ਕੁਐਸਚਨੀਅਰ ਬਣਵਾ ਲੈਂਦਾ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਲੱਗਣਗੇ ਜੈਨੂਇਨ ਕੁਐਸਚਨਸ ਆਈ ਵਿਲ ਫਾਰਵਰਡ ਟੂ ਯੂ ਐਂਡ ਇਨ ਯੂਰ ਸਪੇਅਰ ਟਾਈਮ ਇਨ ਅ ਮੈਟਰ ਆਫ ਅ ਵੀਕ ਔਰ ਸੋ ਯੂ ਥਿੰਕ ਵਿਚ ਇਜ਼ ਜੈਨੂਇਨ ਆਫਟਰ ਮਾਈ ਡਿਸੀਜਨ ਦੈਨ ਯੂ ਟੇਕ ਯੂਰ ਕਾਲ ਵਿਚ ਇਜ਼ ਮੋਰ ਜੈਨੂਇਨ ਅ
ਕੁਐਸਚਨ
ਆਪਾਂ ਸਿਰਫ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੇ ਆਨਸਰ ਕਰ ਦਿੰਦੇ ਹਾਂ
ਸਰ ਬਟ ਆਈ ਪ੍ਰੋਮਿਸ ਯੂਰ ਕਲਾਸ ਵਨ ਥਿੰਗ
ਹਾਂਜੀ
that I will take certain classes, but okay. The thing is, the only thing I cannot promise is when, like randomly, I'll prepare random topics. I'll mostly focus on answer writing. Then here and there we will sprinkle, sir, but
very, very important for students.
But sir, mera ਇਹੀ ਹੈਗਾ ਕਿ ਮਾਈ ਮਾਈ ਟਾਈਮਿੰਗਸ ਆਰ ਵੈਰੀ ਰੈਂਡਮ ਸੋ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਆਈ ਕੈਨ ਗੈਟ ਕਾਲ ਇਨ ਐਨੀ ਟਾਈਮ ਸੋ ਮੇ ਬੀ ਵੀ ਕੈਨ ਆਈ ਕੈਨ ਰਿਕਾਰਡ ਯੂ ਐਂਡ ਸੈਂਡ ਇਟ ਅਕ੍ਰੋਸ ਟੂ ਯੂ ਹਾਂਜੀ ਸਰ
ਹਾਂਜੀ ਹਾਂਜੀ ਸਰ ਬਿਲਕੁਲ ਸਰ ਬਹੁਤ ਵਧੀਆ ਹੋ
ਜਾਏਗਾ ਹਾਂ ਆਈ ਵਿਲ ਰਿਕਾਰਡ ਫਿਊ ਥਿੰਗਸ ਆਈ ਵਿਲ ਸੈਂਡ ਦੈਮ ਅਕ੍ਰੋਸ ਐਂਡ ਦੈਨ ਯੂ ਕੈਨ ਸ਼ੇਅਰ ਵਿਦ ਆਲ ਯੋਰ ਸਟੂਡੈਂਟਸ
ਯਾ ਸਰ ਦੈਟ ਵਿਲ ਹੈਲਪ ਦੈਮ ਅ ਲੋਟ
ਅਲਟੀਮੇਟਲੀ ਆਰ ਇੰਟੈਂਸ਼ਨ जी 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 चलो सर फिर
समा मैं जल्दी फायदा पैसा घर आया मेरे हाथ चो मेरा लैपटॉप गिर गया और पूरा टूट गया लैपटॉप ताई मैं फोन ते करदा पे स्टूडेंट्स कल सुबह मैं क्लास नहीं ले पाऊंगा मेरा लैपटॉप टूट गया है अब कल नया खरीद के मैं परसों सुबह क्लास लूंगा राइट कल की क्लास नहीं ले पाऊंगा मैं लाइव सुबह अनफॉर्चुनेटली मेरा लैपटॉप हाथ से गिर गया अभी इसलिए मैं लेट भी हो गया एंड जगपाल सर थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर ज्वाइनिंग अस
Good night, everybody. We'll be in touch. Okay, bye, sir.
Thank you.